Thank you. This is very pure water, guys. This water was tested, and it came back at a pH balance of 7, which is neutral. It's not acidic, nor is it alkaline. It's just very, very neutral water. And that's some of the purest water you will find within the cave. I have, trust me, it's very good too. Tastes better than Boss, Zephyrhills, all those big brands. Now guys, we're gonna pass two formations on our way down. I want you to hold on to your helmets and take a look at these two babies right here. Here above my head, we have two formations. Now these are like a long distance couple right here. These two formations. Yeah. Now you see what you see that? Now this one we call the chandelier, but this one is the one we call the octopus. This one right here. Now it said that it will take another 20,000 years for these two to form, to connect, and create a column. That's gonna be a long time from here. Formations, you may see some faces, some people see animals. Here we are once again at the beautiful altar. We've had lots of proposals here, we've never had any no's. Lots of love in here. Over to the full stone wall. Now if you can look at the floor, there at the edge, you can see lots of rope happening within the cave. Here we have the full stone wall once again. Now these formations are actually between the ages of 35 and 40 years old. These were formed after the cave was excavated, created this beautiful tunnel. As you can see, that steady drip of water constantly flowing off of these walls.
Something happens. This little beauty right here. Now it's a small boat. It can only go
three persons at a time. Now one person has to volunteer to bring the boat from the ladder back over each time to collect the other two. Yeah? And then we crawl out through there, like 4.5 hours into the dark. Now what will happen, guys, I'll let you know, Rico and I, we will go first, right? Just to make sure it's safe, just to make sure it's safe. I will see you on the surface in about 5 hours, right? But luckily for us, so since the cave was opened in 1981, we have never used that boat for any emergencies. It's going to be used for training. Now as we make our ascension, taking us back to the surface slowly but surely, here we are at our final view of the Great Hall, guys. Now this is a very, very, very beautiful scene for me. As the cave was actually last used within filming a movie, Netflix filmed in here late last year, I believe, for a series called Ultraviolence. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to give any spoilers, but some of the very scenes you see today are within that series. No, that's a different hill. Luckily for us, we don't have any of those people here, right? It tastes good, right? So you see, you missed out the opportunity to taste the water. It's the fucking view, man. No touching the walls, not the water. Now guys, we are leaving behind hundreds of thousands of years, making our way back to the surface. Where we go back to reality, back to our villas, our fast food restaurants, our crystal clear water and our sandy beaches. Salty? Our nice salty beaches. Now, if you guys have enjoyed yourselves, I want you to remember the name, Shay, that's your tour guide. Your driver too, Rico, correct? Now, if you did not have a good time, my name is Roberto, and your driver is Carlos, right? Now, I want everyone to give Rico a round of applause. Did a superb job. And once we reach the surface, guys, we will have a nature trail after the tour. It's like a 10-minute walk. Nature trail, you have the swings, all that beautiful stuff available to take those photos. Once the trail has stopped, guys, you're going to disembark onto the left-hand side. The helmets will go into the brown box. The airliners go into the trash can. And I will meet you guys outside for that nature trail. It's a 10-minute walk. You have the swings, all that good stuff available for taking those photos. So I'll see you outside in the next couple minutes.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
See you outside.
Last guys, I've reached the end of my tour at Harrison's Cave in Barbados. Thank you guys for watching now. Thank you guys for watching. So now we're leaving the cave. This is the zip line section. And again, this is the cave interpretation center.
We need to know what happened in this.
So you're not claustrophobic. I don't think so. I did.
Everyone doing the mix that you're right?
No. Not doing the mix. Yeah.
So if you guys doing the nature trail?
Are you doing the nature trail?
Doing the walk?
No.
You don't want them on the swings? Yep. Change your mind, it's this way, all right?
Okay, thanks.
Everyone else there? That's good. So this is the very different shots outside the cave. The zip line section here.
Everything was good.
Zip line section and the different restaurants and shops and so on. Green Monkey Bar and Grill. And the escalator, which I'll be going on to shortly. The swings and so on. Yeah. Thanks a lot for the tour, right?
You coming? Not coming with us?
Oh, all right.
You're doing a nature walk, nature trail. All
right.
It's up to you. It's like a 10-minute walk.
All right. I will come then.
Okay.
Yeah.
We're just waiting for the others to come out.
All right.
So early in the mornings when I come work, like you see the monkeys running up and down the gully.
Oh, they have fun on the obstacle course.
Yeah, this is their playground when we're not here. Trust me, they enjoy it. They're all bouncing all off the roof.
Yeah, we haven't seen anything on this coast. Last time we saw one of these things, West Coast.
You saw many? Yeah.
Just around the house, you know. Yeah, they'd be in the house. But this trip, we don't see any. We're on the East Coast,
On the East Coast or South Coast?
South Coast.
Yeah, it's going to be because it's a lot more populated. A lot, so not really as much.
And yeah, there are a few trees.
Yeah.
It's really mostly arid.
They will also have some, I guess, enclosed. There's like the swamp, lots of swamp area that we have. Some, that's close to like Sinon's Gap. Mm-hmm. We'll find close in those areas, but not as many as within the country.
Okay.
So we're not going on the nature's walk. This is another addition to Harrison's Cave. This is the washroom section of the cave interpretation center.
Engineers, they thought it was dangerous to cut through this type of stone because they feared that once they started, everything above it would have collapsed. Now, if you look, you can see how
it was a pretty good cave.
Yeah, you know, it's very, very soft, very thin touch. So it's very, very, it was very dangerous at that point in time. But you know, Mr. Boyce, he persevered, he went through creating this beautiful, beautiful tunnel that we use every day, right? And this is also why we say not to touch the walls or formations as well in the cave, because it can all be so little
You know how long it took me to dig it out here?
In terms of the entire project for developing the cave, which is the tunnel, the building, the lights, and everything, it took around 5.5 years. So even the parts of the road that we would have driven on, where there's water flowing right beneath us. Can you see the difference between the leaves?
Yeah.
This one,
shinier.
Yeah. This one has a shine. This one is dull. Now, if you pay attention, look at the veins. These veins are kind of protruded. Well, these ones here are kind of like etched into the leaf. Right. Well, this one is called Edo. It's Edo. It goes good in soup. Tastes very good.
Oh yeah.
This one is called elephant ears. Yeah. This one's poisonous.
Okay.
During the Spanish flu, they would have come to the island looking for a cross or anything of medicinal usage or anything that could be used to eat with. And they wanted the edo, but they picked some of these amongst them. Mm-hmm. So on the way back, one of the crewmen on the ship, he was kind of nibbling away at the leaves. And that's where they discovered the poison. Mm-hmm. So they had to discard of them and come back for the edo. Traveler's palm. If you're ever lost in a forest area, tropical area, this is a tree to look for, as it will help you survive a couple days more if needed. This is where you can get a fresh, clean source of rainwater. Within each of these branches, these trees can store up to a gallon of that fresh pump rainwater. So if you want, you can come up the pathway.
Come on.
You gotta see it from this side here. Now listen, within each of these can hold up to a gallon of water. And it's freshly caught water, so it's gonna be a lot better than any pool or pond you see. When you pull back, see it coming up.
Yeah, okay.
Holy shit.
Oh wow.
So what you initially do, you get a knife, pen, stab it, create a hole, catch your water, and you survive for a couple more days. So it's called a traveler's palm.
I need a banana.
It's called a traveler's palm, but I call it a survivor's palm. Now, here we have our banana patch, as you can see as well.
Oh, look at that, yeah.
Now, did you guys know that a banana tree only bears once?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Once it's ripened, you have to cut down the tree and replant.
I did not know that.
Now we're going to be looking at this plant right here. This is a ginger lily. It's not much to the eye at this point, but when it's in its prime state, it's a very, very beautiful plant. A lot more leaves. It has like a red apricot at the top with a white flower. And once that flower is in the light, it kind of looks like it has glitter thrown on it. Very, very beautiful. Now, what we're looking at today, though, is the leaves. We're just looking at the leaves, and I want you guys to feel the underneath of these leaves as well. So just feel the underneath.
Silky smooth, right?
Yeah, it's smooth and true.
Now, once you're in nature, guys, it's always good to know what is around you and what can be used. Over here, we have our water supply, and here we have our toiletries.
Oh, yeah.
Charmin Ultra Soft. No one said you have to be in the jungle and can't be comfortable, right?
You have to survive.
The only thing we're missing right now is the birds. It's scheduled to open the 15th of this month, I believe. This, as well as the infinity pool and the cabana, they're all going to be open up this month. So if you're still here, you can always come back, check it out. These over here, guys, these are called croton. These are all a variety of croton plants. Well, a lot of people use them as like little hedges in their yard and stuff like that. When I was going to school, this was all a part of a game. We used to play called croton 1-2-3. It was a fun game to most. It was nightmares for some. Now, it was usually played amongst the boys, right? The girls always used to look and say we were silly for it. Now, what will happen is that you have a piece of croton leaf. You have to keep pieces of it on you at all times. So you break off these, put it in your top pocket, side pocket, got some stash in your socks. Even in your notebooks, you have some in between the leaves. Because during the day, a random guy will come up to you and say, croton 1-2-3. Yeah. Your goal is to show me a piece of croton. Until you can show me a piece of croton, and it's a group, it's a whole group. So a whole group, they'll be standing around you, croton 1-2-3, and you're getting tucked from all over. All you have to do is do this, and everyone will step back and walk away. Nothing will be said, nothing will be done, and that'll be the end of that. Now, you used to get lashes two ways for this. If you didn't have a croton, you got lashes. And if you did have one, and it stained your clothes, you get lashes when you get home. So it was a you had to decide, do you want lashes at home in private, or you want lashes at school where everyone can see? Home at private, right? So that's where it usually went. Everyone will still have their phone and they'll tell mom, I don't know what it is. Mommy, it stayed in my shirt, I don't know.
You still carry it in your pocket today, don't you? Just because you never know.
I have one in my wallet.
You do.
But yeah, it's been a it was a fun game, but I'd say it was just boys being boys back in the day, right?
Does a tattoo count? Can you get a tattoo?
Ever get a tattoo photo? Yeah. Ah.
Ah, I like that. I'm getting off of that.
That's a childhood memory. I'm going to get a tattoo of a Chrono Leaf right now. I appreciate that. Now from here, guys, you have a variety of different trees. You have like breadfruit trees, coconut trees. There's a mango tree somewhere in the area. At this time, not a lot of them are providing anything. So they're all just here as a... Yeah, they're all just here as part of the green ring.
Yeah, it's
winter, right? Oh, this is all of it. Any monkey? Oh, yeah, I see it. Yeah, I can see. There's a piano.
He's around or on the side. Listen to him. See another one? Up
there. No, we are in their space now, right?
Yeah.
This is their home. And once you capture your photos, you're going to do a 180. Make your way out of the...
It's gone.